Hello, I'm Mr. Arnager, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. And Satguru, not Guru, Satguru Nanak Dev Ji was the second coming of Christ, Jesus. Christ is a spokesman of God, and so is a Satguru, spokesman of God. But in India, you know, people call him Guru Nanak. Gurus are moral teacher. They teach you moral education, and they are three: mother, father, and Brahman Guru. So if you address Satguru Nanak Dev Ji as Guru Nanak, then you have no idea who he was, and then you can't learn anything. You are just fanatic of turban and beard. Sikh is a nadi root. Nadi means what comes out of your mouth. It's not the physical self. It's not outwardly. It's inwardly. Same as a Jew is inwardly, not outwardly. It's a spiritual self. So there are many fanatics produced in the Sikh temples. And so they themselves, the people over there, as in the churches, they call Christ Jesus, Jesus Christ. Jesus is the name, Christ is the title. So title should come before the name, not after the name. So it is Christ Jesus, or Jesus the anointed Christ. So this is the situation in churches and Sikh temples. When they call it Guru Nanak, they are degrading him because he imparted education to your mind, to your spiritual self, not to your physical self. So he is a greater than the Brahman Guru. So when you call Satguru Nanak Dev Ji Guru Nanak, then you are degrading him. And that reflects whether you are a Sikh or not. So a person who is a Sikh, he will always address Satguru Nanak Dev Ji, not as Guru Nanak Dev Ji. And these people, when they were four royal kings, which are, we call them Sache Patsha. Sache Patsha is greater than Satguru. So Har Gobind Ji, Har Rai, Har Krishan Te, Gobind Rai Ji, they were all Sache Patsha, four of them, according to the four Varna. So if you address them as a Guru Gobind Singh or Guru Har Gobind, then you are insulting them the most. Then you are not a Sikh, you know. And that people like that, you know, they suffer during sectarian riots, because they create, they are fanatics, and they create the trouble. When they create the trouble, then they die in thousands. So you can see how many people know that Nanak was a Satguru. Hardly one in a million. So this is the Sikhi, you know, you have. It's not a Sikhi, it's not so cheap. So no wonder, you know, the people, when I preach gospel, they pounce on me without understanding. And I laugh, you know, because they think that I'm alone and they are too many fanatics together, you know. They don't know I'm not alone. My father is with me. I'm solitary, but my father is my support. He made me solitary. I did not become solitary of my own. By the grace of our Father, we become solitary. So here I am going to stress that Satguru Nanak Dev Ji, he gave the general introduction, what was happening in the world and all that. And he also ate meat. So there was no problem eating meat, you know. And after his death, you know, the spiritual headship or the spiritual scepter was passed on to Satguru Angad Dev Ji, who was a true humble Sikh. And Satguru Angad Dev Ji then gave the Sikhi the foundation stone, and Peter had given this foundation stone to the Christianity. You know, the Christians are people of the book. They are not true. They are nothing to do with Christ Jesus. They just vomit it out. In Jesus, you need to be a Christ, because you are drinking the blood of Christ. When you drink the blood of Christ, then you are a Christ, not a Christian. But when you read the books and vomit it out, then you are a bookman called a Christian. So Christians are dead people. Let the dead bury their dead. If you have Christ in your heart with the grace of our Father, then you are the living Christ of living Father, not of the dead book. So the gospel comes from your heart and not from the dead book. So after the passing of the Satguru Nanak Dev Ji, then Satguru Angad Dev Ji, he laid the foundation of Sikhism. Foundation is laid by killing your ego. And ego is mostly dominated in the children. When you grow up, then you pick up some senses. But most children, you know, they are victim of ego. If somebody hit them, they hit it back. In the schools and other things, you see them how they fight. But when they grow up, you know, go to the college, then they don't fight with each other. So people who are led by ego, they are like little children. And as you know, the babies, when they are born, the first food they give them is a pudding, rice pudding, easy to digest. So the babies, they like pudding. And so Satguru Angad Dev Ji, in his kitchen, the speciality was rice pudding. We call it kheer. Rice pudding was the speciality because people he was treating, they were once born, led by ego. So they were like babies. In the same village where he was staying, there was no rain. And people were making hue and cry. No rain, you know, we are dying of food and there, but nobody died. The buffalo who gave the milk, although there was not rain, that means no grass, but they were still producing milk and still the kitchen was preparing this rice pudding every day. So his sayings of Satguru Angad Dev Ji, they are mostly related to physical body. That kill the ego of your tribal father and know that when you were born in a certain tribe, it was not you who took the birth, but our father gave you the birth. So people who distinguish between themselves that, oh yeah, I'm of Jat tribe, he is a Tarkhan, he is a Khatri, Lohar, Tarkhan. They are stupid people. Because when you were you born of your own free will? It father gave us. Same way, you know, people, we are living in England. So if I was born in India, somebody born in England, somebody in America, somebody in in an African country or any other country, where when we are gathered together, if we consider ourselves to be in respect to our physical features, somebody is black, somebody is brown, somebody is white, and we start hating, you know, this man is a black man, that man is a white man, that is once born, that is only what you see with your true naked eye, that's what you are seeing it. But what is of God is inside you, which you cannot see, but you perceive. But when you perceive, you know, that man was born in Africa, and I was born in India, or somebody here and there, we were not born of our own free wills. It is the will of our Father that we were born in certain country and in a certain family. Then you are twice born. So here, you know, Satguru Angad Dev Ji, like Peter was the foundation over which Christ Jesus, I will build the temple. So here is also Satguru Angad Dev Ji laid the foundation for the temple of God to be built. And that foundation was to subdue your ego. So ego is, I have shown it here in the Trinity chart. You can easily understand. This is a secular world, you know, where tribal affairs are done, political. This is once born. These are the people who are led by ego. They are not, they cannot ponder over his word. They can be turned into fanatic. And this is by grace of our Father that you become twice born. And when you become twice born, then you know our Father. And then you have the key to the treasury of our Father. And here you get sealed to serve God. And here by the grace of God, you become one with our Father. You have the very spirit of God then. So that was the wage paid to the 12 at Pentecost by the four men, Christ Jesus. Father in the evening came to the vineyard. He called the four men, Christ Jesus, come pay the wage to your laborers. They were paid. This is the Holy Spirit. So we are dealing with these people here, which is Satguru Angad Dev Ji's territory. This is Satguru Amar Dev Ji territory, and Ram Das Ji, then Arjun, you know. So, kheer or the rice pudding was prepared in the kitchen, and the milk that came, remember that Jesus had the 5,000 fed on 5 loaves. Where from the loaves came? From heaven. So the kheer, the milk that prepared this kheer, was came also from heaven. So it was very tasty, delicious. And in the village, nobody died of hunger. Although there were no rain, people were crying. The buffaloes were giving milk enough to produce kheer. So these people who were not sensible, they were just thinking, no rain, no crop, we will die. But those who were sensible, they could not see any sign of hunger in the village. So they said, they have subdued their ego. They had become sensible, but many were not. So through this hard work, Satguru Angad Dev Ji subdued their ego. They used to have wrestling bouts, wrestling match, promoted them, because physical fitness create love between the people, love between the players. That can be converted into agape, the divine love. So although they were strong, they never hit anybody. They always served. More you can read on the website of Satguru Angad Dev Ji. But this introduction will let you that why in the kitchen of Satguru Angad Dev Ji, rice pudding was dominant. So the other thing that is worth noting, that you don't eat anything from the house of our father. So whatever people bring, it is for the distribution of the kitchen for the strangers to satisfy their hunger, to welcome them. Not that you go there and enjoy the food as if there's a party going on. It is not that. So Satguru Angad Dev Ji set an example or a standard. Satguru Angad Dev Ji and his wife, they prepared the kitchen. Everything they prepared, cooked everything, but they never ate in the kitchen. They will go to their home and with their own hard-earned living, they will cook the food, eat over there, not in the kitchen among the people. So that kitchen was for the public, for the devotees to come and eat. And any money that came, you know, it was distributed. It wasn't put into the bank or anything. And Satguru Angad Dev Ji, he used to work as a making twines. You know, we in India, we have the sleeping bed. We call them charpai or manji, cot. So this cot is woven with strings, and these strings are made out of a grass which is grown wild in India. It's a reef, you know, reef and other thing. So you cut that grass and then you twist it and into strings. So that is what he used to do. That is rendering service to people. That is, we call them Shudarvarna service, because he was the Satguru of Shudarvarna. And his life was simple. He will use the same shirt. He will go work, and when he comes home, he will wash that shirt, same shirt, and while it's still wet, he will put it on his body to dry. That means to keep his body cool, cool-headed. And that is why we have this golden temple, which is the temple of God, which is a replacement of holiest of holy in Jerusalem, in the middle of the water tank. That a Sikh should be cool-headed. He shouldn't be warm. So Satguru Angad Dev Ji used to put on the same shirt after washing until it was torn apart, you know, became so old that you could not put any more. So he did not have a new shirt every day. Whereas when it was this scepter, spiritual scepter was passed on to Satguru Amar Dev Ji, these Sikhs who had subdued their ego, they have become spiritual, capable of understanding his word. So Satguru Amar Dev Ji then had the key to the treasury of our father. So he then uttered lot of sayings in which the people, when he become twice born, he is in doubting stage. So where the doubts are clear, told them not to go for mammon, go for God. Now, because they are sensible, they can kill the animal and eat. Because if you give it to a simpleton, a stupid man, he will kill the wrong animal and destroy the nature. So, in the kitchen of Satguru Amar Dev Ji, meat was allowed. I think I have heard something that in one of the time, meat was cooked in the kitchen. So it was only in Amar Dev Ji's, you know, kitchen it could be cooked, because it was at that time the Sikhs were sensible. And then later on, you know, when they were giving all the preaching, they had the confidence in God. Then they were made to see to serve God. They handed over to Satguru Ram Das Ji, who sealed them to serve God. And when you get sealed to serve God, as Jesus baptized them, Eucharist of sacrifice, or Eucharist of entering into the bridal chamber, and then their reward was their wages, which was Holy Spirit at Pentecost. So then, you know, Satguru Arjan Dev Ji got the wage of Holy Spirit, the very Spirit of God, and he proclaimed that Satguru Nanak Dev Ji is the greatest of all the Christ. The younger Christ was Christ Jesus, as a GPS, general practitioner. He was for a minor illnesses, minor sons of Satan, baby princes of darkness. In India, we are kings and emperors of darkness. So the specialist, Satguru Nanak Dev Ji, was the greatest of all. So he treated very stubborn sons of Satan. Hope this introduction will give you some thoughts. And for more information, please go to my YouTube videos. Our Father God blesses you.